You may be seated. Graduates, distinguished guests, faculty, staff, parents, students, family, friends. On behalf of our Mazur Board of Directors and Administration, we want to welcome all of you joining us today. We'd like to recognize and draw attention to our digital program and thank Ms. Gerber and her team for their tech skills that made that possible. We want to thank Jeff McClellan, our Piper, and our Mazur alum parent for our processional, as well as our junior marshals, Abigail Nelson, Callie Michaelis, Timothy Fang. A couple of quick housekeeping items before we get started. Ms. Gerber and the PrintCom team will be taking care of photos today, so please leave the aisles clear. All of the photos will be available of your graduate at many milestones today, and they will be shared with you. So no need to take up any aisle space as the awarding of diplomas. Each year, I have the opportunity to do exit interviews with many of the seniors in conjunction with Ms. Anderson. After I ask them some thoughtful questions, I then hand over their grad gown, and slowly their eyes start to sparkle or get a little misty, and then the corners of their mouth go from a thin line to a really cheeky grin that just can't be contained. It's another step that I pack away in the history of their time at Mazur. This year, as I completed my final interview, one of the students ran his fingers through his nervous hair and said, "I don't know if I'm ready for this." My message to him and all of our graduates who are a little nervous today is, no, I'm sure that you're probably not ready to be a full-blown adult yet. However, you are ready for your next step. Be brave. You're surrounded with good company. Shakespeare said, "Brevity is the soul of wit," so let's commence the celebration of the Mazur Class of 22. The program today will begin with a special musical number performed by our Mazur Show Choir, Homeward Bound, accompanied by Mr. Leland Spindler, our beloved choir director. Following our musical number, we'll be pleased to hear from our senior class representative, Dallin Butler. Following Dallin's remarks, the Dean of Students, Mr. Simmons, will introduce our Mazur Book Awards, and then our administrative team, department chairs or representatives will award those. Once the awards are complete, we will hear from Viola Day, the 2022 salutatorian, followed by Isaac Crofts, the 2022 valedictorian. Following those addresses, the diplomas will be presented.
I 45 years and 2 days ago, Star Wars: A New Hope changed the world forever by showing in theaters for the first time. The Death Star and millions of voices were suddenly silenced as a story's explosive impact. What was it that George Lucas did that made the tale memorable? He followed an archetype that made the very best stories, that the very best stories mirror, known as the hero's journey. This pattern of heroes is one that has, can, and will describe the great tales of our own adventures, particularly the tale of the graduating class of 2022. By understanding this timeless cycle, we learn that the adventure of senior year has been comprised of roughly four parts of the hero's journey: the call to adventure, the crossing of the threshold, the cycle of death and rebirth of our old selves into something new, and the gifts we receive at the end. Think back to the summer before your senior adventure, of what countless teachers and fellow students said to you as you stepped through the major front doors last August. "You're gonna graduate? That's gross." Or, "Wow, you're so old." Were they right? Of course they were. None of us could change that senior year was coming. None of us could ignore that we were next. We would all receive the same call to adventure and accepted it, moving forward despite the unknown. Yet, in the words of Gandalf the Grey, we have to decide what to do with the time that is given us. Thus came the next step of our senior year journey as we wandered into the first period of the year, the crossing of the threshold. This means that we have to overcome our individual mental blocks, face anxieties, focus on the tasks at hand, and push into the future. Everything, from the moment we first sat down in the tiny squeaky chairs in the Senior Socratic Room to right now, was a preparatory state from a preparatory academy. Thus, we arrive at the crux that many of us have anticipated: the death of our old lives and the birth of our new ones through graduation. After late nights of cramming for exams, writing last lectures, and finishing capstones, our childhood has escaped us, no matter how desperately we might have tried to keep it in our clenched fists. Yes, it is true. We are technically now adults. And yes, the adventure that was senior year is now over. Yet, accepting that we are, and most importantly, can become adults, is the first step in becoming someone worthy of that distinction. And now we come to the final step of the hero's journey, receiving the gift we have sought. Heroes, you see, always receive gifts at the end of their journeys. Luke Skywalker got a medal and a smile from Princess Leia. Nice. What was it for you? Knowledge? A diploma? Freedom from the smell of burnt popcorn? If you allow Mazer to change you for the better, your new self is what you will take with you at the end of this night. Yet, this time, you will also be giving a gift back to Mazer as well. This year, as you considered a senior gift, our senior class presidency has decided on a doormat for the front of the school emblazoned with the Mazer logo. To the senior boys that danced their hearts out with me at Mr. Mazer, thank you. To those who helped me and supported Mr. Mazer in any single way, thank you. The money we raised from that event, although crazy and full of weird dancing and 80s costumes as it was, thank you guys, because that is what we will leave a legacy from for all those who enter the front of the building. What we have gifted today as a class will provide the first welcoming step for future students, faculty, and alumni alike. Graduation is not really a 200-pound weight wrapped around our necks and meant to sink us below the depths of despair. No. It is the circular door of a hobbit that we must all sprint out of to go on yet another unexpected journey. Our adventures do not end here. No. We can, and will, emerge triumphant through whatever adversity awaits, as battle-beaten as we may become. Life is an adventure. We are stepping into the unknown. May we all come off conqueror and be improved for the better when we meet again. Accept the call to adventure. What will your next one be? Thank you.
Books play a major role in the education of a student at Mazer Prep. Books function both as a window and as a mirror. A window because through books we develop a lens to understand and see the world. The seniors this year have studied Viktor Frankl's Man's Search for Meaning. And I think it's fair to say that in looking through that lens, your perspective is different. Books also function as a mirror through which we can examine ourselves. Socrates said that the unexamined life is not worth living. And so books function as a mirror, not to see ourselves in, but to see who we can become in the process. And so in accordance with our normal tradition, we would like to award seniors a book. And so we will have the representatives from each department come up just in order, and we'll work our way down to present the department book awards this year.
Hello, I'm Crystal Anderson, and I'm the high school counselor for the 11th and 12th grade. This year, the counseling department has chosen an amazing student who, in spite of personal tragedy, I have seen metamorphose into a butterfly. I have never seen, oh my gosh, here it comes. You might as well just get ready for me to cry the rest of today. This student is awesome, and I just love her so much. JC Darger, please come up. The book, The Path Made Clear, Discovering Your Life's Direction and Purpose by Oprah Winfrey. JC has had quite the path, as all seniors do, looking for and searching for where will I go, what will my path be. But whatever this woman's path is, it's going to be awesome. Thank you so much. And this is great. This student, his understanding of science is amazing. And he has a million ideas in his head all of the time. He thinks deeply and about the hows and whys of how something is happening. He sees connections between chemistry and physics and biology and uses those connections to explain the world around him. He tries to see other connections between what he's learning and now what he's already experienced. He's even asked the question, like, how does Bernoulli's principles work with the sprinklers in my yard? He likes seeing the application of science in everyday life. He is going to be an amazing engineer. He has a technical, scientific mind, but at the same time is creative and artistic. He loves designing projects and making prototypes, and he is constantly sketching his own designs for new products. The science department is excited to give the book award to Isaac Crofts.
This year's PE Department Book Award, I'll say the name and then I'll read, but it's Madeline Wooten. This is actually written by Coach Grosbeck, because he's had more contact with her. Madeline is a weight room rock star. During her time in our weights program, she has drastically improved her strength. She has also done a great job at mastering the lifting techniques that she has been taught. One of her greatest attributes is her ability to help and motivate her peers. She is always helping others correct their lifting technique and motivating her lifting partners. We have thoroughly enjoyed her and will miss her in our program.
We have so many talented mathematicians in this group of seniors, but there's only one of them that took four math classes beyond the required core, including three AP classes and an elective proof course. There's only one of them that participated in the Mazur math team consistently. There's only one of them that shows a love and passion for mathematics that extends beyond the classroom into their daily life. There's only one of them that consistently finds beauty and solace in math to the point that they chose to write poems about it. There's only one of them that shows that somehow has found a way to mathematize nearly everything in their life, including and not limited to love triangles. There's only one of them who spends hours after school in the math building working on math for fun, that is, when they aren't sleeping in the halls. I'm honored to present this Math Department Book Award to Connor Nagata.
The Fine Arts Department would like Lauren Lee to come up. Being the senior most instructor at Carl G. Mazur, I've gotten used to seeing students walk the road of artistic development from their first tentative steps and on towards true mastery. But with Lauren, I didn't actually have that kind of experience. She joined my AP art class just this year without having taken other art classes from me at Mazur previously. In fact, I had some reservations about having her in my class at first because I didn't know who she was. But despite her beginning status within the Mazur art program, she took the creative process with a natural affinity that I've seldom seen before. Building on solid foundational skills, she advanced quickly in what seemed like no time at all. Lauren was pushing the boundaries of tradition, pad and palette, weaving her love of music, acoustics, and the science of sound into the very fabric of her art. Lauren's work is nothing short of astounding. Her portfolio investigations create a seamless synthesis between method, medium, and meaning. For this reason, and because of her encouraging attitude and inspiring work ethic, I have selected Lauren to receive the Senior Book Award on behalf of the Fine Arts Department.
I'm Mrs. Frampton, and I am so honored to be presenting the Socratic Book Award to an exceptional human, Ethan Lewis. It's really hard to describe what it's like to have Ethan as a student in my class. That I wrote in his yearbook that sometimes I just want to put on a Coldplay album and wander around his brain. It would just be a spectacular sight, I'm sure. Ethan approaches the learning process with a soft heart, open ears, and outstretched arms. Mr. Simmons says of Ethan he's willing to hold two seemingly opposing and conflicting ideas in tension while looking for a way to prove those contrary. I will add that he often does this with a spur-of-the-moment visual illustration on the board, a diagram or a graph of some sort, to show us whatever concept or principle we are discussing. Rarely does he make a comment in class where he doesn't support his point with not only the text at hand, but with something he has read or learned outside of class. Ms. says that he treasures books. They are his friends, his mentors. He never tires of spending time with them, and he is insatiable in his quest for truth and beauty. Mrs. Cannon adds that Ethan seeks out extra learning and education. He reads extra books, attends concerts, and engages teachers and peers in conversations about ideas and principles. Plus, he's super creative and funny. His writing about the third draft gets really insightful and brilliant and fun. I have had the same experience with Ethan. I would call Ethan, as a writer, a light-hearted, deep thinker. Reading a personal narrative essay written by him is always a three-dimensional experience, even when he is writing about how much he hates pigeons. When he writes, he can move you effortlessly between a coffee shop bookstore in Montana to a smoky jazz cafe where Billie Holiday is sitting across from him with a cigarette between her fingers. Once he wrote about the first time he heard Chopin's C minor nocturne, and suddenly he was a rocket man taking us all into space. Ms. puts it best when she said he communicates through his writing, but also through his music. He transcends the constraints of vocabulary and helps to nourish and educate the whole soul. Mrs. Martinez's favorite thing about Ethan, besides his insta-laugh, is his spontaneity when we ask him to play the piano in class. Even though he is so good, he is so humble about it. He's like, I haven't prepared anything, but maybe I could do a little Bach. Ethan has been ruminating quite a bit on dreams this year. To quote a line from his last lecture essay, you are not great because of your dreams. You are great because of your passion to pursue your dreams. We dream to push our character, to tap into our greater potential. We say goodbye to some dreams to make way for greater dreams. Because Ethan is currently trying to figure out what to do with a deferred dream, we chose a book of jazz poetry by Langston Hughes. We also chose Pigeons Have Feelings Too. And lastly, we chose a book called A Million Miles in 1,000 Years by Donald Miller. Ethan, we know this book can help you live a better story, but we're hoping it will also help you dream a kinder dream.
Mr. Travis Harmer and I share a name, almost. His name is Harmer, my name is Harmon. It's that last letter that mixes quite a few people up. At least in sometimes the office staff, when they have so many teachers to keep in mind, and also parents sometimes will mix us up as well. But we assured each other, at least, because he's a Spanish teacher, I'm a Latin teacher, we assured each other that at least the students probably wouldn't mix us up. Because what's the likelihood someone's going to have Latin and Spanish? And even if they did, surely not in the same year. Well, somehow, somewhere, there was a student that heard our conversation and said, "Hold my horchata." And that student was Josh Clayson. Josh's teacher this year we've all taught Josh because of who he is and what he's taken, but his teacher this year couldn't be here today. That was Mrs. Jeanette Steiner, so she left her remarks with me, and so this is what she said about him. Josh Clayson took all of the Latin classes he could up through AP Latin, all of the Spanish classes he was able to up through CE concurrent enrollment Spanish 2010, which is Spanish 4. And on top of that, he made time to consistently study Japanese on his own. Josh is an excellent student. He brings a positive and fun vibe to class, and he stands with Mazur for truth, honor, and virtue. Josh is one of our students who has really learned to embrace the culture and empathy side of language learning. And that is one of the many reasons he is so deserving of this award. Though he has enjoyed and become proficient in both Spanish and Latin, his true language love is Japanese. So we are pleased to present him with this book of Japanese myths and legends. Josh has a love for world languages and cultures, and the World Language Department is proud to claim him as our kind of nerd. We wish you luck as you continue your studies of Japanese, Spanish, Latin, and whichever other languages and cultures strike your fancy throughout your life.
Thank you so much. Congratulations.
Today is a day that's all about you, so naturally I'm going to talk about me. You see, I'm a hypocrite. I'm a big hypocrite. I mean, this comes as a shock to some of you, but a surprise to absolutely no one. Because I have railed against a Mazur tradition for years. I've ranted, I've shared my not-so-subtle opinions about giving two awards. And then it came my turn. How do you choose? How do you choose between the editor-in-chief or the person whose quiet leadership and beautiful design inspired the most beautiful book? How do you choose between the person who has placed more photos in a national photography competition than anyone in the history of said national photography competition, or the person who took first? How do you choose? Do I abandon my principles of choosing only one? Or do I ignore someone who I love very dearly? And I teach at Mazur, truth, honor, virtue. I can't abandon my convictions. So I will not be giving two book awards. So yesterday, we gave department awards, and the business and technology department did not give one. So, book award, department award. You know who you are. Come on up, both of you.
Words are hard. It was easy when I was talking about me. Both of them have taken 3 years of photography. Both of them have mastered digital design. Both of them have been leaders. And all those memories that you have, all those photos, all those yearbooks, all those videos, all those Instagram posts that you see have gone through these two. Zan is a master of beautiful, thoughtful design. And Neen is the master of finesse. Zan is artful in his photography, and Neen tells stories. Zan got a car stuck in a mud, causing us to have to dig it out for over 4 hours, and Noreen did not. They're both well-rounded, studying so many different subjects, stats, calculus, student council, soccer, all of it. They've both helped me through my own personal tragedies through the last 4 years, and both of them have gone through their own and allowed me on that journey. They're creative, they're mindful, they are wonderful, and they are not getting the same award today. I love you both.
I'd like to start off with the obligatory but well-deserved thank yous. Thank you to all the parents for supporting not only your own children, but frequently kids you have no blood ties with as well. We couldn't have made it without all your donations, hairstyling skills, and time. Thank you to all the other family members who willingly subjected themselves to Utah weather so that they can clap for the ones they love. Thank you to all the friends for giving your time and love to people who were fortunate enough to meet you. And thank you to the teachers. Your help, ranging from filling out last-minute recommendations and helping us with homework, to listening to us cry away our troubles and opening stupid car doors, is the reason us graduates are here today. Throughout high school, I would listen to certain songs during specific occasions, and other songs, like the unofficial school anthem, Sweet Caroline, would just pop up out of the blue. One of these songs was Let's See How Far We've Come by Matchbox 20. Its lyrics depict how when the world is burning to the ground, the only thing we can do is look back and see how far we've come. I personally listen to it after moments I deem life-changing and milestone-worthy. Naturally, I blasted that song after our senior class gained the best secretary ever, Andrew Lyons. Now, I'd like to take a moment and actually look back at how far our class has come. Back in seventh grade, we were all adorable. Seriously, I looked over the class pictures and little Leo's dimples are to die for. We numbered 109 back then, and over the years, 40 of those people are still part of the 75 graduating seniors here today. Those people have grown a lot since seventh grade. For Andrew Pitcher, that grown is literal. But for the rest of us, it means a lot of different things. For example, we used to say Mazer sports after a failed skill shot or any feat lacking in athleticism. But thanks to Isaac Allred in track, Dan Chavez in soccer, Trex Davis in basketball, and so many more skilled individuals, that joke no longer applies to our school. We were once such horrible students that our poor, meek ninth grade Socratic teacher had to have an ambulance called in to examine him in the middle of class, partially because we were so stress-inducing. This year, however, we impressed newcomer Clarissa when we didn't move an inch after the bell rang because we wanted to finish listening to our beloved Socratic teacher's talk. We won the Spirit Bowl back in seventh grade and have saved up all of our motivation since then to win it again this year. Thank you, Cooper Skousen. We don't deserve you. We were finally able to go to a prom this year that Gerber can't call the butthurt prom because the school didn't plan it. There, we crowned Anton Don and Autumn Perry as the royals they deserve to be, because you'll never find anyone sweeter. We all discovered that Ethan Streeter is one of the funniest people around if you'll only give him a podium to speak from. We remembered to take off that non-uniform jacket before Dowdle yelled at us, "Get in uniform," for the 100th time. We realized that having conversations with Greg, Talon, Shayla, and everyone else in the grade can actually be pleasant when we put in the effort to do it. We learned that our friends will betray us in an instant during Senior Assassin. Sorry, Christian. Speaking of, congratulations, McKinley Dunn, Kelsey Williams, and Celine Gunther for getting the most confusing kill ever. And congratulations, Annalie, for actually winning. we eventually picked up on the fact that when you write an essay overnight, it tends to not be good. Unless you're Ethan Lewis, then it's positively brilliant. We figured out that a cloud can prevent us from watching the sunrise, even when we're all gathered around the marina waiting for it to appear and fulfill the age-old senior sunrise tradition. We also got to watch the sunset behind a cloud together when the time came. As the year came to a close, it occurred to us that many of the things we were doing would be for the last time. Our last time seeing Kelsey's bad parking job. One last time watching Connor lie on the Socratic Room's carpet. One final time catching up with Amelia. One more genuine compliment from Nicole, and one last pun from Joseph Yachman. As reality settled in, we realized that after today, our lives will never be the same. People will move, jobs will be started, dreams will be lost, and friendships will fade. That doesn't mean that what we did here didn't matter. Even if you never see Max or Elena again, the paintings you saw and poetry you heard matter. Even if you only got to see Meg dance and hear Casey's music the one time, those times mattered. Even if the person you call your best friend today goes thousands of miles away and doesn't come back, that does not mean your relationship amounted to nothing. Something doesn't matter because of how long it lasted. Things matter because while they were around, they meant something. Our time at Mazur may have been ephemeral in the grand scheme of things, but it meant something to us graduates for every moment we were here. Whether it's the time you sang Let It Go with Alyssa Lowry by your side at 1 a.m. on the bus ride home from Shakespeare, much to the dismay of Mr. Holtz, or when you read during Essay Cafe for the first time and couldn't help but feel a swell of pride that you did. We will all carry Mazur moments with us for years to come. High school isn't the end of our lives, just the ending of a favorite chapter. We'll move on and find new moments to add to the collection of memories we already treasure, as I'm sure each actual adult in the room can vouch for. And when the moment that we reminisce over our high school days inevitably arrives, we will be able to look back and say how far we've come. But for now, I'm glad to say that this year was filled with Cole's iconic hats, Dallin's infectious smile, Olivia's little drawings, Scott's wonderful accents, and moments made by us graduates that matter to us graduates. Lastly, I'd like to thank all of the 75 seniors, because every single one of you is the reason that during this year especially, good times never seem so good. Thank you.